Hello, hello, good evening.
Hi, teacher.
How's it going?
I'm still driving to home.
You're still driving home. Okay, be careful. Be careful. Okay, guys, let's just wait a little bit for your classmates.
Nos la van a llevar, se lo mira tomando la foto, te dicto.
What? Okay, guys. So today, in today's lesson, we just have to talk. That's the lesson for today. One second. Vamos a esperar unos minutitos para que vengan sus compañeros. Si tienen alguna pregunta, aprovechamos ahorita. Un segundo. Sorry. Okay. So, questions. Any questions? Con todo el contenido que hemos visto hasta ahora, do you have any questions? Think. Okay, what was the last topic yesterday? ¿De qué hablamos ayer, ya por último?
Preposition of time.
Prepositions of time, for example.
At, on, in.
Okay, good. You're looking at the book. That's great. Okay, give us an example, Michelle.
An example. I'm going on vacation in August.
Good. I'm going on vacations in August. That's right. In for months.
I rest on Sunday.
I rest on Sundays. That's right. Very good. Liz? Microphone.
Perdón, hola.
It's okay. Uh-huh.
I sleep.
No, well, I go to sleep.
At night.
Time.
At time?
At 8 o'clock, at nine.
Ten.
At ten. O'clock. After the ten class. O'clock. Okay. At 10 o'clock. Yeah. After the class. Remember the other prepositions. Eric.
Teacher, está mal decir at night.
No, I sleep at night. Pero no estás especificando a qué horas, right? Duermo en la noche.
Ah, porque ya entendía yo que at era para específicos, así como la hora, exacta. No.
Sí, según lo hemos visto hasta ahora, Edwin, sí, es bien específico, at night. Okay. Ahorita solo lo hemos visto como prepositions of time, preposiciones de tiempo.
Sí.
Ok, Eric.
Hi, teacher.
Hi.
I watch TV at 10 o'clock.
Oh, really? And the homework? Not really. Where's the homework? At 10 o'clock. Okay. I watch TV at 10 o'clock. Maybes.
Hi.
Hi. I mean, hello, how are you?
How do you say in English, dolor de cabeza?
Headache.
Hi.
Headache.
Headache. I have a headache.
A headache. Ready? Headache. Yes. Stomachache. Headache.
Headache.
Mm-hmm. Back pain. And so on. Okay, can you use a preposition? Yesterday we started in, on, at.
In, on, at.
Mm-hmm. Do you remember yesterday? In, yes. On, at. Okay. Carla Vanessa, please turn on your camera whenever possible. Gloria? Okay.
Hi.
Oh, Flora, okay. Bien, okay, it's okay. It's okay, Lorena, it's okay. Yeah. Okay, algunos tienen problemas con el internet, Gilberto y Flora. Lorena, me dicen que tienen problemas con el internet. Cuando eso les ocurra, sí, apaguen la cámara. O sea, es más fácil para la conexión de internet transmitir audio que video.
Exacto.
Right. Okay, good. Okay, les recuerdo el nombre completo según su DUI, please. Okay, so yesterday we said, so let's play something really quick. Vamos a jugar algo súper rápido, okay? Everybody. Yo digo el nombre, ustedes dicen la preposición que corresponde, okay? Good, if I say Sunday.
In.
On. Sunday.
On Sunday.
On
okay.
Sunday.
Very good. September morning.
In
September morning. Perfect. In September. Very good. Okay. 5 o'clock.
At
7 o'clock. I mean, at 5 o'clock. Very good. Okay. Let's see. What about the morning?
In the morning.
In the morning. What about evening?
In the evening.
In the evening.
In the
evening. Very good. Lunch.
At lunch.
At lunch. Good, Eric. Very good. Same as dinner, right? Say. At dinner. At dinner.
Okay. At dinner.
So if I tell, how do you say then, te veo en la cena?
I watch at dinner.
No, te veo en la cena.
I see you.
I see you
at dinner.
At dinner. Sí, I see you at dinner. Ojo, I see you at dinner. Te veo en la cena. Perdón. Sí, en la cena. Ahora, si la cena es muy importante, es un evento que tenemos en casa presidencial, ¿ok? ¿Cómo dirías entonces? Te veo en la cena. Come on. Es las primeras cosas que les dije.
I see you in the dinner.
I see you in the dinner. I see you in the dinner. Hey, I see you in the dinner. Te veo en la cena. Muy importante, ok. Good. Wednesday.
On.
On Wednesday. On. Yeah. On Monday, on Tuesday, and Wednesday. Ok, days of the week. Very good. The weekend.
In weekend.
In the weekend?
In the weekend.
Hmm. Look at the.
Sábado, domingo.
Yeah, look at the triangle. Miren el triángulo. Look for the triangle. Who's got it? ¿Quién lo tiene? Yep, there it is. Saved it somewhere. Can't remember where. Okay.
On the weekend.
On the weekend. It's on. Very good. on the weekend. Don't forget it. It's very important, okay? What about 1981?
In 1981.
Excellent. How do you say de
1972
Okay, from two guys, from 1979 to 1992, on February 16th, what happened on February, no wait, January 16th, what happened on January 16th, or was it February? Was it on February? No, it was January 16th. January 16th, 1992.
La firma del acuerdo de paz.
Yes. Okay. Very good. The peace agreement after the Civil War. Good guy. Good guys. Okay. So it's 8:11. Let's start the class with your homework. Pero antes yo quiero de plano quiero saber quién sí ha estado siguiendo la rutina de hacer un verbo y una palabra positivo, negativo, pregunta, ya sea con el verbo to be o con el presente simple. ¿Quién sí la ha estado siguiendo? Eso me deja saber que nadie lo ha hecho. Ok. Nobody, nobody hubiera dicho que era requisito para pasar o algo. Ok. That tells a lot. Eso dice mucho, chicos. Y hoy lo vamos a ocupar porque vamos a hablar muchísimo este día. Se llama Vocabulary Review. Vocabulary Review. Revisar vocabulario, a ver qué tanto hemos aprendido. Lo vamos a hacer en diferentes contextos. So, let's start. Vamos a comenzar con nuestra dieta diaria, ¿ok? Si no tenés, si no has hecho algo, pues comienza por buscar la lista, el listado de verbos, ¿ok? Keep it handy. No busques verbos tan, no escojas verbos tan regulados, tan irregulares. Tan rebuscados, ¿ok? Ayúdale un poco a tu compañero también. Un ejercicio que te podría ayudar mucho ahorita, si ya tienes cierto conocimiento de inglés, varios de ustedes lo hacen, es retarte a ti mismo y tratar uno de explicar con sinónimos, ¿ok? So if I tell you, let's see. You use this to drink water. You use this to drink water. You can also drink refreshments, beverages, horchata. You can drink horchata with this. What is it? ¿Qué es? What is it?
Beverage.
Yeah, but you use this to drink water. To drink beverages like horchata. What is it?
Glass.
A glass. There you go. Okay. Good. And so on. Okay. Traten de ocupar, describir los objetos en lugar de preguntar directamente la palabra en español. Número dos, use biomechanics. Usen biomecánicas. Okay. So if I tell you, smile.
Smile,
good,
smile.
Okay.
See.
See, sí, there you go.
Think.
Think, okay. Eso te va a ayudar muchísimo a tener creatividad también, okay. Y retar a tu compañero, good. So, let's do it. Homework, how do you say? How do you use it? Come on, come on, come on. Let's go.
Beatriz, ya está en la pupusa. Chile, agárralo.
Ya va.
Hola.
Hi. Hi, José Ángel. Hi, Yancy.
Hola.
No me había visto de despeinada.
Ay, no tengo internet en la compu y tengo que estar en el teléfono. Y no lo veo.
Ay.
Ah, ahora sí.
Pues sí, le tocó. Sí. Sí. Va llegando a casa, o sea, she's coming home.
Sí, casi siempre sí. Llego.
Arriving to house.
How do you say llegando a casa? ¿Cómo dicen? Llegando a casa.
Arrive.
Oh my God! Nobody tells me, teacher, the microphone. Arriving.
Arriving.
Okay. She's just arriving home. She's just arriving home. Okay, come on. Let's do it. So how do you say llegar? In English.
Yeah. I say to arrive.
You say arrive.
Arrive.
Okay.
Arrive.
How do you say hogar in English?
Home.
Okay.
Home.
How do you use it?
Yancy?
Say.
Hello?
Say hi. Don't say hola. Say hi. Okay.
Llegar.
Okay. So how do you use it?
Sí, pero se me olvidó la pronunciación. Arrive.
Arrive.
You got it. Arrive. Arrive.
Arrive. Arrive. Arrive at home
arrive.
Or arrive in home?
Arrive.
In home,
man. At home.
At.
Es más, no lo ocupes, no ocupes preposición ahí. I arrive home.
Arrive home.
Arrive home.
I arrive home at 7:05. Okay.
I arrive home.
Mm-hmm.
I
7 o'clock.
Yes, yes.
Estoy diciendo. Espérame, es que no lo veo.
¿Y para qué me quiere ver? Escuche mi voz.
Para ver cómo
su pronunciación, su modulación.
Okay, good.
Negativo. I don't arrive at. Ahí va.
No diga at.
No.
I don't arrive home.
I don't arrive. Arrive home at 8 p.m.
Okay, I don't arrive home at 8 p.m.
I don't arrive home
at 8 p.m.
Y question.
Principal área de oportunidad ahorita. Estoy sonriendo muy bien. Pero, Yancy, cerremos los labios al decir la M. Ok. I don't arrive home at 8 p.m. Very good.
I don't arrive home at 8 p.m.
Diga home.
Home.
Very good. Home.
Remember homeboy.
Home.
Yeah. Después hay muchas palabras que terminan con M. Mom.
Mom.
Ham. You know ham.
Martillo.
No, ham. No se ve la panza.
Ham.
Jamón.
Ham.
Ham.
Yeah.
Ham.
Teacher, si me conecto ahorita de la compu, llegaré a este mismo grupo.
Yo me puedo encargar de eso. Yes.
Porfa, es que tengo un lío.
Okay, go, go. Okay, guys, practice, practice. How do you say, how do you use it? Come on.
How do you say ejercitarse in English?
In English.
In English.
Exercise.
How do you say gimnasio in English?
Gym.
How do you use it?
Exercise. Cualquier persona.
Any people, any person, yes.
I exercise.
At the gym.
At the gym. En ese caso sería at the gym.
At the gym.
At the gym. At the gym.
The gym. The gym. The gym. Right. Places. Common places like dentist, doctor, gym, the mall, super, el centro comercial, the mall. Siempre va a ir con el artículo the beach, the dentist, the supermarket.
Okay.
Hmm? Good.
Ahora, turno de Edwin. Lorena, le puedes preguntar a él.
Edwin, how do you say...
De Tim Marín de Doping, güey.
Está siguiendo listados de verbos.
Sí, de verbos es ninguno.
Ini, mini, mini, mo.
No. Uno rebuscado, que para. Hacer.
How do you say hacer in English?
Uf. In English.
Edwin. I don't know if Edwin is still driving. Edwin? No.
Do.
Yeah. Okay. Do, you say do. Good, Edwin. Okay, now the word. The word, Lorena.
How do you say... Pastel. Bueno, ahí sería cocinar, ¿verdad?
Mm-mm. Bien, aclaremos esto. Make y do. Okay. Make, cuando haces algo con las manos.
Elaborar algo.
Elaboras algo, that's right. You make a cake, you make loving fun. Fleetwood Mac. You make loving fun. En cambio, do es más de acciones que no implica mucho la transformación de una cosa a otra. Like, I do homework. I do my exercises.
How do you say rutina diaria in English?
Daily routine.
Daily routine, okay.
How do you use
it? How do you use it, Edwin?
She does. She does exercise in her daily routine.
She does exercise on her daily routine. Ella hace ejercicios en su rutina diaria. Yeah, that works. What's the negative?
She doesn't.
Yeah, she doesn't
do exercise.
Excellent. She doesn't do exercise. Mm-hmm.
Daily routine.
Perfect. What's the question?
Does she do exercise in her daily routine?
Perfect. Very good. Okay. Good. Continue. Continue.
Eric.
Sí. Yes.
How do you say? Rebajar en inglés.
Rebajar.
De peso.
De peso.
Lower.
Mm-mm. Está rebuscada. Okay, you say get underweight.
Get underweight. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Lose weight,
pero es que depende del contexto. Uh-huh. Y muy probablemente estás pensando en los verbos de necesidad. Yo necesito, yo no necesito, yo necesito yo. Get underweight, yeah, lose weight. Let's see.
Pero porque es underweight, peso, underweight.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Lose weight, get underweight.
How do you say comida?
Food.
Food. Esto está interesante.
And how do you use it?
Let me see. Okay.
Edwin, ¿qué oración estás pensando?
Como él debe comer menos para rebajar, algo así.
Él debe.
Se me ocurre una oración.
Comida saludable, teacher.
Healthy food. Pero,
¿cómo se decía rebajar, teacher?
Get underweight. Está en el chat.
Get underway. Por ejemplo, Rafael, get underway by exercising and eat less. Baja de peso, él baja de peso con ejercicio y comiendo menos. Y come menos.
Rafael loses weight or Rafael gets underweight by eating less food.
Eating less food. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Eating less food. That's right. Exercising and eating less food. You said that's good. So Rafael gets underweight by eating less. Right.
Eating less food.
Good. Good job, Eric. What would be the negative?
Rafael doesn't get underweight. By eating less.
You're good. Eating less food. Excellent. And
question: does Rafael get underweight by eating less food?
Perfect. You got it. Okay, guys, keep going.
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Thank you, guys. Hello.
Hola. Tenemos una duda.
Sí.
Me too, yo también.
Qué pena.
Quiero saber si está maduro ese aguacate, ¿no? Oh, yes, it is. Okay, potasio. Very good.
That's... Sorry.
Okay. No, me estaba riendo porque... Mi perro tiene como 15 minutos de estar diciendo papá allá afuera. Es que es un husky, miren, si escucharan hablar ese perro.
¡Hablar!
Habla, si no lo saco después de la clase, se pone el... Bravo, papá, papá. Ay, Dios mío. Y cuando no hay agua en el huacal, guau, 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 guau. Ay, Dios mío, ya voy. Es exagerado. It's crazy. Ajá. What's the doubt? What's your doubt, Michelle?
¿Cómo se traduce? Ella viaja a Estados Unidos en Navidad.
She travels to the United States. It will be on Christmas.
On Christmas. Christmas.
Holidays.
We
ahí estaba en el cuadro.
We use the article with the countries.
My birthday on Christmas. Yes. No. Sí. No con todos. Les decía que el único país que tiene el artículo en su constitución es the United States of America. Y lo dije mal. The is the United States.
Ah, ok.
The United States. Okay. Good.
Show teacher me. Was at.
At Christmas? At Christmas. Uh-huh. No. It's on Christmas. Okay. Así como on your birthday. Oh. On your birthday. Okay, she travels to the United States on Christmas. En Navidad. Podrías decir for Christmas.
Para Navidad.
Uh-huh. Every Christmas. Todas las Navidades. Yep, okay. So, Ofelia.
Ofelia is not here.
Why? Internet connection?
Maybe.
Ofelia, hello.
Hello, teacher.
There you go. Okay. Ofelia, how do you say soñar in English?
Soñar. Es son.
No, a ver, soñar de cuando duermes, ¿no? Soñar.
Soñar. S-U-N-D, ¿cómo se pronuncia?
No, eso es sonar, eso es sonar.
Es soñar.
Soñar con ñ, ajá. Como no, es que no le reconoce la ñ, el teclado. Es con N, ajá. A ver, you say dream. Dream.
Dream.
Oh. Uh-huh. Dream. 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 Very good. Dream.
Dream.
Okay. How do you say dormir in English?
Dormir.
I'm sorry.
Sleeping.
Sleep. Sin, cuidado con la ING, no estamos viendo ING ahorita, ok? So, okay. Sleep. So, tenemos dream, sleep. How do you use it in a sentence? ¿Cómo se utiliza en una oración?
Sería, I hope sleeping.
No estamos viendo ING, no va el ING ahí. Ok, I dream. Ahora, veíamos hace poco los conectores, ¿no? ¿Cómo digo cuándo en inglés?
Es... Why?
When. Okay.
When.
Okay. When. I dream.
I dream.
When I sleep. Era lo que... Espera.
When I sleep. I dream. When I sleep.
Right. I dream when I sleep. When I sleep. ¿Cuál sería el negativo, Michelle? What's the negative? I dream when I sleep.
I don't dream when I sleep.
Okay. And what is the question, Ofelia? ¿Cómo es la pregunta?
Sería... Where I am... Dream. Sleeping.
Sería do I.
Do I.
Dream.
Dream.
When I sleep.
When
me faltó el question mark. So, Ofelia, necesito que practique la estructura. Acuérdese, sujeto, verbo, complemento. Sujeto, verbo, complemento, ¿ok? Sujeto, negativa, don't o el doesn't. Verbo, complemento. So, ahí tenemos, I dream when I sleep. I don't dream when I sleep. Do I dream when I sleep?
Okay.
Good, good. Let's go. Sweet, wonderful you.
You make me teacher, happy question. Teacher.
Yep.
Y decimos como él juega o él le pega la pelota en el juego de béisbol, sería at the baseball game or in the baseball game.
In the baseball game. Let's see. He hits the ball in the baseball game. At the baseball game.
At the baseball game.
A ver, entendamos, no hemos visto preposiciones de lugar, prepositions of place. Pero in es dentro de un lugar. At es en el lugar. Como punto de referencia.
At.
Pueden ser ambos.
O como lo queramos decir.
A baseball court. A baseball court. Un campo de béisbol. Estás dentro. Puedes ocupar in o at. Como sea.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome. Someone else?
Victoria? What do you say, cortar?
Everybody,
how do you say?
Cortar.
Cortar is...
The pronunciation is cut.
There you go, cut.
Cut, okay.
That's right.
I tell, ¿cómo es? Yo decía, cute.
Cut, yeah, I know. Todos decimos cut o cutter. Right, la herramienta cutter, no, it's cut, cutter. Cut, cutter.
No, teacher, decía cute, como oh, de cute, bonito, creo.
De bonito, ajá, como el teacher, ajá. You say cute para decir bonito, right? Okay, cute is something else. Cute,
algo. Entiendo, teacher, ¿cómo, how do you say lavadero?
Oh my God, yeah, that's a good question. Esa es una buena pregunta porque en Estados Unidos no hay lavaderos.
Guachero
dicen los mexicanos allá en Estados Unidos que se le dice el guachero, pero no hay lavaderos, tampoco hay huacales, chicos. ¿Por qué? Why?
Vasijas.
No hay pilas. Bueno, sí, de hecho hay piles.
¿Y cómo hacen?
Hay piles. Pues, ¿cómo se hace? Porque así tenés que tener una secadora y una lavadora. Si no, hay lugares donde tú vas y metes una cora y se lava la ropa.
¿Por qué? A los locales les dicen pilas.
O solamente el lavamanos, ¿verdad?
Sí, sinks. That's right, sinks. De hecho, sink podría ser una pequeña pila, el sink. El lavadero. Okay.
Yo viví en Santiago de Chile. Y tenía que lavar en la tina porque no había lavadero.
Porque tú tendes ropa y se congela. Sí. That's simple as that. Makes sense. No hay tanto calor allá. En Chile creo que sí, en alguna temporada, a ver, ¿no?
Okay. Y las cuatro estaciones. Four stations.
The four stations, the four seasons. Seasons.
Thank you.
That's right, it's okay, don't worry. Yo salí a hacer lo mismo. No es que me ría de ti, sino que me acuerdo de mí. Ok, y después, mira, si ahorita tú te grabas, grábate diciendo tu rutina como te salga. ¿Sí? Va a ser un buen recuerdo ya cuando hables súper fluido. Va a escuchar y va a llorar de la risa. What? Ok, good guys, let's continue. So, on your workbook, Tan, 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 tan. Tan, 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 tan. Where is it? Where's the workbook? Oh, my God. Wait. There it is. Ok, alguien está pasando por lo mismo que yo, que el perro no deja de ladrar. Ok, so, we have an exercise. Using the information from exercise 2 in page 35, remember? This exercise, this little chart. Here you said, Jose, the activity, wakes up, and here, at 6 a.m., right? Ok. Mavis checks reports, okay, at 8:30 a.m. on Mondays. Okay, so here we have to use that information to tell what activities your classmates have to do. Okay, so vamos a ir un paso más adelante para no hacer esto aburrido. Vamos a ocupar has to. Como vas a hablar de terceras personas, ¿ya? De tus compañeros. So, for example, José diría en su activity, no sé, José, ¿me puedes decir una oración de las cosas que haces por rutina en tu trabajo? O, ¿ya?
I prepare a financial report every Monday. Hmm.
Okay, he prepares the financial report every Monday. Eso sería lo común, ¿no? So ahora le vamos a agregar esto. He has to prepare. Ojo, ¿eh? He has to prepare the financial report every Monday. Podríamos agregarle un poco más. At, José.
At 11 a.m.
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 Okay. A.M. Very good. A.M. Okay. That's one. Ya tenés una. So, vamos en grupos que tu compañero te diga una actividad que tiene que hacer y cuándo la tiene que hacer, a qué horas la tiene que hacer. Okay. So, I have to teach, or diría, I teach English. Okay. O simplemente, mira, complicamos la vida a los demás. Teach English. Okay. On Monday at 8 p.m. On Monday at 8 p.m. Teach English on Monday at 8 p.m. Okay? Entonces tendrías que decir Rafael has to teach. Okay? Or he has to teach English on Monday at 8 o'clock. Okay? Let's do it. Questions?
What is the meaning
of?
Yeah.
Of what?
Él preparó o él tiene que preparar.
A ver, estamos, él tiene que preparar. Estamos siempre en presente simple, chicos. Él tiene que preparar. ¿Ya? Yeah.
Ok.
El deber, el tener, es lo que vamos a aplicar un poco, aunque no es parte ahorita del módulo, pero vamos a avanzar un poco en eso. El uso de una tercera persona y su obligación me hace ponerlo en tercera persona este verbo. Mas sin embargo, el que continúa, no, no necesito ya la S o la ES ahí. Ojo con eso. He has to cook, he has to jump, he has to study, he has to, she has to sleep. ¿Ya? Responsibilities. He has to present reports, he has to prepare reports. Okay, let's do it. Vamos a aplicar eso rapidín en grupos y luego regresamos. Estamos en, we're on page 36. We are on page 36. Okay, let's go again. Okay, let's go.
Verónica Isabel.
Ok. Yeah. Ok, ¿quién comenzaría?
Who start?
Excellent.
Yancy.
Ok.
yo, I prepare the check. How do you say proveedores?
You say providers or vendors. Most common vendors.
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 Y el término...
Vendors.
Yep, the vendors.
Suppliers
are fine.
Supplier también.
Ajá.
Yeah, you can say that.
Okay. I prepare check to supplier.
Or the suppliers.
Okay. Or de nuestros proveedores.
Sorry, tengo mala conexión, así que voy a tener la cámara desconectada.
Check.
Okay.
Y then...
for the supplier. Ah, ya. Yeah. Entonces, digamos que sería she has to prepare the check for the supplier.
For the suppliers, okay. When? Meow. Mm-hmm. When?
Next.
Ah, no. Se me salió el Miyagi, sorry. No. Okay. When? ¿Cuándo, chicos? Date. ¿Cuándo? Date and time. Ya, fecha y hora. Come on, guys. No me mira así.
Ah. ¿A quién le dices?
A ti, ya.
Okay. Hey, que puedo decir de a tal hora y sería es correcto from night
on. Primero vamos a decir on porque vamos a decir un día, ¿no? Lo que vimos ayer. On.
Yo iba a decir every day.
Ah, okay. ¿A qué horas?
¿Sí es correcto decir from?
Sería every day. Cuando digo every day, no ocupo preposición alguna. Entonces digo, she has to prepare the check for the vendors or for the providers every day at...
At 9 a.m.
Vamos, 9 a.m.
Night N M.
A ver, oíme primero.
Nine.
Me estás diciendo al final. Nine. Perfecto, ahí, 9 a.m.
Nine a.m.
9 a.m.
Quiero decir desde las 9 a las 11.
Oh, between sería entre.
Between 9 a.m.
And
Dígale correcto y yo lo repito.
Okay, between 9 a.m. Uh-huh. and 11 a.m.
11
a.m.
Okay. Next.
Tramposa. Dijiste que ibas a repetir. Come on, you can do it.
Between 9 a.m.
And
a.m.
A.m.
and? And 11 a.m. Next.
Teacher.
Yeah, Rafa.
If I want to say de las 9 a las 11.
Eso es diferente. Ahí sí aplicamos lo que quería aplicar Yancy. From to.
Uh-huh. 9 a.m. from to.
From.
From.
Mm-hmm.
La hora.
9 a.m.
To.
To 11 a.m.
11 a.m. That's right. Correct. Correct.
What other activity do you do, Yancy?
I know, Rafa. I visit my friends every day. Cada vez que puedo, como puedo.
Every time I can. Every time I can. Okay, good guys. Should be.
Es que extraño los de mi ex departamento.
Okay. No me dejen en la luna, Liz, por favor. Come on.
Gilberto. Me perdí cómo se dijo. ¿Cómo se decía? Hello. Cada vez que puedo.
Every time I can. O más, okay, más americano. Whenever.
Every time.
Whenever I can.
I can.
Whenever I can. Whenever I have time. I visit. I visit my friends. Whenever I have time, I visit my friends. Gilberto, welcome. Creo que Gilberto sigue teniendo problemas con su conexión. Lorena igual, a Lorena no le he escuchado en este grupo. Okay, hello Gilberto.
Hola, hola, hola.
Yeah, hello. We can hear you. We got you. What activities do you have to do?
And the company's applications, sometimes we have meetings from 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. My day is very repetitive.
Repetitive.
Hello?
My day is very
repetitive. Thank you.
Yep.
Repetitive.
Okay. Good guys. Thank very you. Good. Okay.
Gilberto, excuse me. Can you repeat the what se prepara?
I write code for application.
Okay.
Y así se me va todo el día.
And that's how the day goes by.
Can you spell it scout? Bit scout? I don't understand.
What this word? What word? I'm sorry.
Lo que hace, hay una palabra ahí.
Right. W-R.
Right.
I.
E.
T-E, that's right. Right. W-R-I-T-E.
Right. Right. Grite. Con doble U.
Okay.
Okay.
Raja.
Yep.
Finish.
El otro Raja.
Okay. Let's go.
Your activity.
Oh, Rafa didn't say his activities. Okay. Time's up. Okay, you have 50 seconds. 50 seconds.
Chair.
Hey.
How do you say cada uno de ellos in English?
You say each one of them.
Each one of
them. Each.
Each.
Each one of them.
Each one of them. Literal.
Literally. Literally. Okay. Each one of them. You could say every one of them. But I studied this, not todos ellos. Every one of them. Just each one of them. Cada uno de ellos. Okay. Any other question? So let's see. Ivan, good evening.
Good evening.
Hi, Ivan.
Sorry.
Who are your classmates? Who are your classmates?
Maybes. Eric.
Eric. Okay, let's see. What does maybes have to do? What does Mavis have to do?
She has to complete the case tracking system.
Oh.
At 5 p.m.
The case tracking, repeat tracking.
Tracking. Tracking.
At 8 p.m.?
5 p.m.
Oh, at 5 p.m.
Yeah.
She has to complete the case tracking system at 5 p.m. Yes?
Maybe que da seguimiento a los casos. ¿Cómo se dice eso?
Oh, good. Okay. Maybe does follow ups on cases.
Follow ups. Okay. Okay.
Maybe it does follow up some cases.
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Every day, every Monday, every Tuesday, every Wednesday at... Da-da-da.
Every day.
Okay. Every day at... What about? At about? Uy, gran dislexia, vieron. At about 3 p.m., let's say. Okay. Maybe it does follow up some cases every day at about 3 p.m. Maybe it da seguimiento a los casos todos los días alrededor de las 3 p.m. Cerca de las 3 p.m. Okay? Good. Se me ha metido una pestaña. No crean que les estoy haciendo ojitos. Okay. Good. Let's see, Eric. Eric, what does Ivan have to do?
No la noté, teacher.
I didn't pay attention. Okay. Good. It's okay. Before we continue.
He has to pace the report every day, your boss at 8:30. He has to pace the report. Every day, your boss at 8:30.
Okay, escribí el ejemplo de Mavis para que me ayuden a corregirlo entre todos. Esto es un ejercicio que voy a estar haciendo seguido, así de que acostúmbrense y no se sientan mal. Si lo que ustedes dijeron ha sido elegido para que lo corrijamos en el pueblo, en común. Ajá. ¿Quién me ayuda a corregir esta oración? He has to paste. o escribiste past? Sí, maybe.
You have to present.
Excellent. Okay. Now he has to present the report every day your boss at 8:30 a.m. ¿Qué más estaría, habría necesidad de corregir ahí?
De la preposición.
To his boss.
To his boss. Permítame, yeah. José, tú dijiste preposición. Vamos a hacer un ejercicio rápido. Pausa.
Preposición.
A ver, ¿quién me ayuda? Aparte de José, ¿quién me puede identificar preposiciones en esta oración, chicos?
Her boss. Her boss.
No. A ver, sí. Vamos a corregir eso, pero antes, viendo la observación de José, ¿quién me puede identificar preposiciones en esta oración?
Sería his.
Hay dos.
No.
At, very good. At is one.
Two.
Y two. Very good. That's it. That's it. Good, guys. Eso quiero probar, que ya pueden identificar partículas de una oración. So he has to present the report every day. Aquí necesitamos otra preposición y corregir el adjetivo posesivo. Possessive adjective. Remember, it's not your. Tuyo. ¿De quién es el jefe?
His.
His. Ok. Entonces, ¿qué preposición voy a ocupar antes de his? Dirección.
Of.
To. A su. Literal. A su. En dirección de. A su. So, there you go. He has to present the report every day to his boss at 8:30 a.m. Ya pasó. Wait, sorry. Okay, so he has to present the report every day to his boss at 8:30 a.m. Good. Esas sí son las preposiciones. Habría que corregir el posesivo adjetivo. El adjetivo posesivo, okay? Before we move on, antes de que continuemos. One second. One, two, three. Ada Patricia Linares Galdames.
Here.
Ana Michelle Guevara Sanchez.
Here.
Blanca Argelia Fabian Mejia. Don't see her. Okay. Edwin Rolando Mendez Chicas.
Here.
Eric Gabriel Salvador Benavides.
Here.
Flora Lorena Chávez Campos.
Here.
Gilberto Eli Mendoza Rosales. I think he's here. Gloria Elizabeth Linares Galdames.
Here.
Jennifer Carolina Gallardo Chacón. José Ángel Pereira Romero.
Here.
José Marvin Portillo Argueta. Karen Alexis Juárez Vigil. Carla Vanessa García de Pérez.
Here.
Mavis Yvette Milla Contreras.
Here.
Néstor Iván Ramírez Galeano.
Here.
Félix Reyana Arce.
Here.
Thank you. Rafael Ernesto González Ventura.
Here.
Reinaldo Bonilla Martínez. Verónica Lizeth Sánchez Pérez.
Here.
Yancy Lisbeth Hernández Mejía.
Here.
Y más es de apellido Hernández. Ah, no, ya no. My God. Ya me acordé. Anyways, good. Let's move on. So, now what? Bien, espero que hayan comprendido un poco el ejercicio y qué propósito tenía. Creo que la mayoría solo se dedicó a preguntarle al otro las actividades que tenía. ¿Quién fue un paso más allá basado en lo que hemos visto?
Yo.
¿Cómo? Perdón, se le cortó. ¿Quién habló? Perdón. Ivan. Fue Edwin. No sé quién habló. Ok. ¿Qué es ir un paso más allá? Por ejemplo, diría Rafael. Rafa, help me. Has to. One activity. an activity that you do, you perform?
Keep.
Mm-hmm.
Keep. The financial accountant.
The financial account. Financial accounts, las cuentas financieras.
Every day.
Good. Every day. Okay, Rafael has to keep the financial accounts every day. And, por ahí decía José, also, y además, he has to.
I prepare.
The coffee.
Okay. Ajá, es cierto, Rafa.
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
No, se lo lava la taza y yo se lo hago.
Ay. ¿No será que le queda mejor a Rafael? Por eso lo ponen. A mí me pasa eso. Solo yo sé cómo hago el café.
Teacher, okay. How do you say libro de compras?
The purchase book.
No, lo de coffees.
What?
Quítalo del coffee.
Oh, yeah, of course. Okay. He has to prepare the purchase book. Okay. How do you say, a ver, ¿quién de los tres me contesta esto? Que se están haciendo bullying entre ustedes de ese rato. Vamos a ver. How do you say conciliación bancaria in English?
My boss is expert.
Account reconciliation. Reconciliation account.
Oh, Carla también es accountant, right? Reconciliation.
Account. Okay.
If I'm not wrong, it's accounts counseling. Bank accounts counseling. Can you check? Conciliaciones bancarias. Check. Is that right?
Yo tengo aquí bank reconciliation.
Bank reconciliation.
Está muy textual.
No, pero sí es. No, por lo menos el sistema sí lo dice.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
What?
Textual, easy.
That's right. Okay, let me check. I no les creo. Oh, yeah. Esa es consejería, yeah. Counseling.
For example, Penny Cash es caja chica.
Penny Cash, right.
Penny Cash.
Mm-hmm.
Literal, el español es efectivo para gastos menores. Si se traduce literal.
Mm-hmm. Can't believe it. Conciliación bancaria. Bank reconciliation. I was wrong. Thank you. Okay, so ese era el punto de la actividad. Que harán ese cuadrito de esa manera. Una rutina completa. Okay. Next step. Work with a partner. Couples. Working couples. One is A and the other person is B. Work with the words from page 37. Where's page 37? This same page 37. So you have to unscramble the words. Bien, esto se trata de que el que va a hacer A va a ocupar las palabras en la página 37, que es en la que me encuentro ahorita. Y el que va a hacer B va a trabajar con las palabras en la página 38. Ok. So, this is basically the purpose of that game. Este es básicamente el propósito de ese juego, ¿ok? You have to determine what someone do. So let's start. Oh, it's too much. Okay, let's start by checking here. I go to play now. Okay, so can you see the screen? Okay, what does he do? What's his job? What does he do? Oh, that's better. What does he do? What's his job? Nobody?
Panadero.
Baker, baker, very bakery. Good. Alguien dijo bakery, okay, bakery es panadería. Y si sé que bakery es la panadería, ¿cómo se diría panadero? Se diría baker.
Baker.
Mm-hmm. That's
baker.
Baker. So, what does he do? What's his job? He's a baker. That's his job. He's a baker.
What does he do? Equals what's his job? He's a.
So you can say he's a. He's a baker. He's a baker.
He's a baker.
Okay. What does he do, Rafa? What does he do?
He has to make bread.
He has to make bread. Very good. Or he prepares bread, he cooks bread. He has to prepare bread. Perfect. Okay. What does he do? What's his job?
A barber.
He's a barber. He is a barber. Verb to be. He's a barber. What does he do?
He has to cut hair.
He has to cut hair. Great. He has to cut hair. A barber. Okay. He has to cut hair. Easy. Okay. What does he do? What's his job?
Bartender.
Mucho dentro de un par de minutos lo van a ver. Today is Friday. Yeah, that's, he's a bartender or a barman. Barmaid. ¿Por qué barmaid?
Barmaid.
Barman. Men. Barman. A barmaid woman. Okay, a woman. Got it? Male, female. Male, female. Barman, barmaid. So what does he do?
He prepares drinks.
He prepares drinks.
Drink.
He or she, well, he prepares drinks. She prepares drinks. No esperaba la respuesta de Michelle. Oh my God. Okay. What's his job?
Carnicero.
Yeah, English. Butcher.
What's butcher.
He's a butcher. Very good. He's a butcher.
Butcher.
Butcher. He's a butcher. Okay. What does he do?
He cuts meat.
Cut the meat.
He cuts meat.
He cuts meat.
Okay. Prepositions. To sell.
To sell.
Para vender.
To sell.
Mm-hmm. To sell. Bien, hago una pausa. Ya les había explicado eso, pero creo que sería una buena oportunidad para abundarle un poco más. So we are saying he cuts meat. Yo puedo decir to sell. Ojo. He cuts meat, ojo, for sale. Why? ¿Quién se acuerda de esta lección súper rápida de un minuto que le di entre 2 y 4? ¿Me puede explicar? Yancy, don't let me down. No me dejes abajo. Don't let me down. Edwin, don't let me down.
Two is for a verb.
Yes, two is for a verb. Uh-huh.
Four is for a noun.
Oh my God, perfect. You got it. Two for verb, four for noun. Sell, the verb. Sell, the noun. Okay.
Uh-huh. What is the difference on meat or beef?
Oh, that's a good one. That's a good one, Jose. Meat, beef. Wow. That's meat, that's beef. ¿Sabes qué creo que una está cocinada y la otra no? What you're eating? I'm eating beef.
Beef, beef is for cow.
Ajá, es que beef es, eso sí, vienen de la, dos vienen de la vaca, pueden venir de la vaca. ¿Será que beef es específicamente de vaca?
I think so. Because you don't say beef of chicken.
It's probably. Chicken
beef? Ajá, uh-huh. Nunca lo he visto. Chicken meat, sí. Thank you, that makes a lot of sense. Eso tiene mucho sentido, jamás me había puesto a... Porque sí he visto mucho el uso de beef, pero en roast beef, por ejemplo, en la carne rostizada que ya viene preparada, roast beef. Lo que le ponen a los Subways, roast beef. Gran comercial que me acabo de echar. Ok. Good, pero el punto es, ok. Después de two es un verbo, después de four es un noun. Don't forget it. Y sí, le va a pasar eso, eso es bien común. Mira, sell es el verbo y sell es el noun. Entonces, él corta carne para vender, él corta carne para la venta. What? Mm-hmm.
Do you use another verb, chop? Chop?
Yes, you can say he chops.
Chop.
Solo que chop es picar.
A picar.
Yeah, picar. Chops meat for sell, chops meat to sell.
Pero chop, 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 chop. Así es, ¿verdad?
And then you cut.
Ah, ok.
Puede ser más específico y decir that he cuts slices of meat. Corta, ¿cómo dijiste? Slices, tiras, así como,
como cuando dice una
pieza, rayada. Rayada.
Rebanada,
una rebanada. Excelente, una rebanada. Tampoco vamos a decir el raleya, ¿ve? El raleya acá no. Ok, good, next. Thank you, guys. What does he do? What's his job? Oh my God, look at that face. It's like,
that... He's a liar.
He's a liar, ok.
He's comparing it to maybe.
Liar.
Oh, come on. He's a lawyer, not a liar.
Lawyer, lawyer.
Maybe too.
Liar and lamina.
It's the same. Liar, lawyer. Okay.
So, pero ese lawyer. Tiene, pero tiene cara de pícaro.
De pícaro. Yeah, okay. This guy is a seller. Okay. A state agent. A seller. A state agent. ¿Nunca han escuchado eso? Real estate. Real estate agent. What's a real estate agent? Someone who
tiene raíces.
There you go. Thank you. Beautiful Spanish. That's right.
Yes. Sorry.
It's okay. Okay. So, real estate agent. He's a real estate agent. He sells.
Sell house.
Houses.
Houses.
He sells houses.
Properties.
Mm-hmm. Bien, vamos un paso más allá. He sells properties. He sells houses. I'm a lawyer. Okay. For a living. What do you do? I sell houses for a living. I sell houses for a living. I teach English for a living. I teach English for a living. ¿Qué quieres? ¿Qué estoy diciendo, Carla?
¿Qué enseño inglés para vivir?
Para vivir, o sea, a eso me dedico, pues. I teach English for a living, eh? I love numbers for a living, dirían los accountants. Amo los números para vivir. Ah, come on, you love numbers, guys. You love numbers. Okay, what does he do? What's his profession?
Oh, he's a chef.
Chef?
He's a chef. Excellent. Chef. What does he do?
She makes food.
For a living. Very good. He makes food for a living. Excellent. You see? Good. Okay. The dentist. What does she do?
She cut the teeth.
She cuts teeth?
No. Take care.
I like that. Who said that? He takes, she takes care.
Oh, she takes care. Oh.
That's a good one. She takes care. She takes care of teeth for a living. Okay. She takes care of teeth for a living. Ella cuida de dientes para vivir. Suena raro, ¿no? ¿Por qué? Porque le falta el objeto indirecto. She takes care of others. Okay. Like that.
For a living.
She takes care of others' teeth for a living. ¿Alguien que me traduzca esa oración?
Ella cuida de los dientes de otro para vivir.
Perfect. De otros. Very good. De otros. Right, she takes care of others' teeth for a living. Perfect. See, you can speak English now. That's easy. Oh, this is a new word for you. It was new for me too.
Fisherman?
You know, a fisherman... It's more for the sport. Fisherman is more for the sport.
Okay.
And the action. And the action itself. But this guy gets the fish, he prepares the fish, and he sells. And he sells the fish. This is the profession. This is the profession.
Fish seller?
Fish sale?
I didn't know that. Yo no la sabía. Yo no la sabía tampoco. It's a fishmonger.
What?
I said the same thing. What? I said the same thing. What?
What?
Like, what? Interesting.
Oh my fishmonger. Fishmonger?
A fishmonger.
Fishmonger?
It's vendedor.
A new word for me.
Vendedor de pescado. Vendedor.
No, it's just pescador. Same thing.
Pescador.
Google it. Okay. So what does
today
a
fish...
esa canción de Ice Cube es buenísima. Today was a good day. Hey.
Yeah.
What does monger mean?
Just the word monger by itself, nothing.
Monger?
Fishmonger.
Okay. It's a one word.
It's
monger is only for the fish, fishmonger.
Because Iron Man, el malo era Iron Monger.
What? Iron Monger?
Como cazador de.
What does it mean? What does it mean, teacher?
Ferretero.
Iron Monger. ¿Qué?
Ferretero.
Ferretero?
Yes.
No tiene que ver con herrería.
Este es pescadero. Pescador. Pescador.
Pescador, man.
Wow. I'm learning. Okay. Good. Ironmonger. Didn't know that. Okay. So what does he do? He sells fish. He sells fish. He has to sell fish for a living. Okay. What's her job?
She's a flight attendant.
Yeah. She's a flight attendant.
Flight attendant.
She's a flight attendant. Very good. What does she do for a living? Oi, what does she do for a living? How do you say atender in English?
Attend.
Attendance?
Mm-hmm.
Flight attendant.
Thank you, Mavis.
Attend.
Okay, so what does she do for a living?
She attended other people, no? The people who...
She attended.
Who travel?
Passenger?
Jude Jose, okay.
Yeah,
Let's put it together. She attends...
Passenger.
In?
Along
in airplane?
In an airplane. In an airplane. In an airplane, that's right.
Okay.
She attends passengers in an airplane. Good, guys. Got it. Okay. Again. Oh, this guy is something else. That was a barber. And this is a hairdresser. What is a hairdresser? What does he do?
Hairdresser.
Stylist.
This is a hairdresser.
Oh.
A hairdresser. I guess the difference is that this guy dyes hair. So I'm gonna write it for you. A barber doesn't dye hair. Girls, who dyes her hair? Liz?
What does dye mean, teacher?
Okay, a hairstylist does. Barbero no tiñe pelo. ¿Verdad, Liz? Un barbero no tiñe pelo. A hairstylist does.
Tiene todo, se le puede.
Un estilista sí lo hace. Esa es la diferencia entre un hombre que corta pelo y un estilista. Que tienen teñido el pelo.
Otra cosa, ¿no?
They go like, welcome, let's do your hair. Oh, my God. Yeah. I go to a stylist. Yo voy a un estilista, no un barbero. Okay. Yeah, por años. And he's good. Okay.
Okay.
Bueno, de Lobelto, se llama. Lobelto. Okay. What is this guy doing? What does he do?
He's an electrician.
Electrician. What is the word? Electrician or electricist?
Electricist.
No, electrician.
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 Let's see. Electrician. Yes, electrician.
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 Electrician. Okay, what does he do for a living, Jose?
Pela cable.
No, something else.
He repairs cables.
He does
play with bolts for a living.
He plays with bolts for a living. I will say I play with my life for a living. I play with my life for a living. Juego con mi vida para vivir. My God, that's dangerous. That's really dangerous. Okay, you got the idea. Very good, guys. How many are we missing? Oh my God, it's 31. I'll send you the link, okay? Les voy a enviar el link de esto. Let's see. Good. Oh, sí, no, no, estuvo bien. No. Esos son flashcards. Ustedes pueden buscar topics, temas de ahí para poder describir professions. Pueden encontrar temas ahí de cualquier tipo y jugar con las flashcards para aprender viendo las flashcards. Ok. Just one second, please. Un segundo, por favor. Okay, good. Let's continue, guys. Sorry. So on your workbook, we still have some details to work on. So these are professions. You have to work with a classmate. The same thing we just did.
Lo mismo que acabamos de hacer, vas a hacer con un compañero. No. Y le vas a preguntar.
No, wait, someone said no. Boring, aburrido. No, too difficult.
Yes.
Is it too difficult? Okay.
Hay que descifrar de lo que es cada numeral.
Yes, pero vamos a hacerlo un poco divertido. So, for example, I will tell you. I will tell you. Te voy a decir. Son mis compañeros, ¿sí? I have to count money. I have to count money every day. La pregunta es, who am I? ¿Quién soy yo?
A cashier. You are an accountant.
I'm a cashier. Good. I'm a cashier. Oh. Voy a cambiar el, una perspectiva, el contexto. I have to steal money. Every day, I have to steal money every day. Who am I? ¿Quién soy? Who am I? Mm-hmm. I'm saying I have to steal money.
A thief.
Very good. I have to steal money every day. Okay. ¿Y le preguntas? Who am I? Okay. Professions. You can say a robber or a thief. Being a thief, is that a profession? ¿Es una profesión ser un ladrón?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. It's difficult. It's difficult. You have to.
Yes, it's difficult.
Okay, ya no, ¿cómo sabe?
Politician.
Oh,
good. I think so.
Entonces, ustedes le van a decir a su compañero, I have to do this. Podrías añadir el for a living. I have to steal money every day for a living. Who am I?
I have to do this.
Ese es el punto. I have to do this for a living. Who am I? Who am I? ¿Quién soy yo?
A living.
Okay. Pueden ocupar estas profesiones que están acá. Okay. O, por ejemplo, acá, ¿qué será lo que dice? Research and development.
Marketing.
Marketing. Very good.
Marketing.
And this?
Accountant financial.
Finance and accounting. Good. Jose, you got it. Marketing.
Finance.
Finance and accounting. What about here, Jose?
Production.
Production. Good. What about here?
Purchasing.
Very good. And last one.
Human resource management.
Good, Jose. Wow.
Human resource management.
Very good. Human resources.
It's singular.
Human resource management. Very good. Hey, good job. Okay. Pueden ocupar esas professions o u otras que ustedes deseen, okay? But let's make it fun. Hagan lo que les decía, ¿no? I have to do this. Tengo que hacer esto para vivir, okay? Good. Let's recreate the rooms to make this funnier. Okay, let's go.
Start, Rafa.
Okay. I have to make people love.
¿Cómo? Excuse me.
I have to make people laugh.
Ah.
How do you say la frase or the phrase para vivir?
You are a comedian?
Yes.
Or you say for a living, for a living.
For a living. Okay. Or clown. Payaso is clown.
Clown. Pero ahí tendrías que decir yo soy un payaso.
Clown.
For a living.
Ya voy a venir.
Sí. Le vamos a esperar. Sí, como ya. Next.
Come on. So in that case it was I make people laugh for a living. Yo hago que la gente se carcajee para vivir. Ellos tenían que adivinar, Rafa. You are a clown, sos un payaso. Igual, esa es una expresión, ¿eh? You're a clown. I make people laugh. For a living, el ejemplo de Rafa. Okay, next.
Okay.
I have to make dresses for a living.
Okay.
You are
so beautiful. You are designer.
To me. A designer. Is that designer. The word? Is that the profession or? Yeah, because, yeah, the male profession is tailor. A tailor is un sastre, right?
Tailor.
But no, you Rafa and Ivan, me, we could be tailors. Podríamos ser tailors, sastres. Pero, ¿cómo dijeron? Dress designer. A designer. Yeah.
Dress designer.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Okay, next.
Good, good. Keep going, keep going.
I have to
Okay. Due diligence to the court.
Due diligence. No, of sociedades. O sería, how do you say sociedades in English? Sociedades. Due diligence for society.
For societies.
For societies.
Para sociedades. What about organizations?
Mm. Organizations.
Mm-hmm.
Él me preguntaba qué hacíamos donde yo trabajaba y le digo que vemos más temas de reestructuraciones, fusiones, sociedades, due diligence. Es legal, pero también es contable y hay auditoría.
Ok, no haces mandados, haces diligencias.
Diligencias. Investigaciones de cómo está una sociedad, por si va a otra a comprar una sociedad a otra. ¿Cómo está?
Financial studies. Estudios financieros, ok. Feasibility studies. Estudios de factibilidad.
En cumplimiento de obligaciones legales y eso. Pero okay. Interesante.
So, who am I? ¿Quién soy? Te falta preguntar. Who am I?
Se fue. Y creo que Lorena está en sick.
You're a lawyer.
Yes.
Not a liar.
Lawyer.
Excellent.
And Edwin?
Okay. It's too difficult because I have to do a lot of things that doesn't represent my career.
For example?
Because my position? My position is more administrative. But my career is for a technician. Okay. I'm go to imagine what is more representative for my career. I have to building house or edifice
or I have to build houses or houses. buildings.
Houses or buildings. Okay. Mm-hmm. Or ¿cómo se dice carreteras? Ways.
Roads.
Road.
R-O-A-D.
Is a project manager.
No. Are you?
Yes.
Project manager.
Good. Are you a project manager?
Yes.
That's the way. Are you a project manager?
Excellent.
Yes, excellent. I have to build.
Very interesting.
It is. Can you imagine? All day building buildings, building roads. Y tenés algo que va a durar por mucho tiempo. Vas a decir, yo hice eso. Oh my God, right. Okay, that's really good. Great job, guys. Okay.
Lorena, no.
We lost her. Okay, let's go back then. Vamos a regresar a unos que hay una actividad.
Okay.
You are so beautiful to me. You are so beautiful to me.
And the others.
Can you see that?
The others.
He's sleeping. He fell asleep. Can you see?
Yes.
He's snoring. Está roncando, te lo juro. It's so funny. Tan gracioso. Siempre tiene que estar cerca de mí. Si no, se desespera. It's crazy.
Eden, my. ¿Cómo sería? Igual los míos.
Same with mine. Ajá, igual que los míos. Igual con los míos. Pero yo he llegado al punto de morderle las orejas a este. Si no, no me respetaba. Y es cierto, le mordes las orejas porque es Hoshki. No es broma, él se creía que era el jefe. Así, de plano, mordía y de repente, yo, what? Hasta que lo agarré a la fuerza. Y nos peleamos y un día se me mordió el brazo. Y le mordí la oreja. Desde entonces, never. It's funny. It's crazy. Okay. So I have to cut wood and make furniture for a living. I have to cut wood.
You're a carpenter.
You're a carpenter. Good. Carpenter. You got it? Cut wood and make furniture. Furniture. Muebles. Okay. For a living. Very good. Give me another example. Someone else.
How do you say curar in English?
Good.
Cure.
I have to cure. I have cure. To heal. I have to heal. I have heal. To cure. Mm-hmm.
Cure.
Cure.
Curar qué? People.
People? Yeah.
Okay. I have to heal a nurse. People.
A nurse.
So you're a nurse. Yeah? Okay. Hay muchas cosas que hace la nurse. How do you pronounce?
Sacerdote.
Oh, well, priest. Buena película.
The priest.
How do you say curar? Cure. How do you say priest? Cure. Don't someone.
¿Puedes hablar inglés? Yeah. Cure.
Good. Uh-huh. So I have to listen to people. No, I have to listen to crazy people all day for a living.
Psychiatra?
No. Well, yeah.
No. Psychologist.
Psiquiatra sí es para gente con desórdenes mentales, creo.
No, she's right.
El psicólogo es medio loco.
Psychiatrist. Look for the writing. Psychiatrist. I have to solve people for a living.
Chiropractor.
Hey, never go to a sobador in El Salvador, okay? Never go to a sobador. You can.
¿Y el que es el fisiatra, el que da rehabilitación?
Ese que yo que me dijeron. Okay, you say physiologist. Todo lo que empieza con PH y griega, chicos, okay? That's the point. Very good.
Teacher, how do you say necesidades fisiológicas in English? It's similar physiological.
Very similar, yeah. Physiological necesities. My God. I have to repair cars for a living.
You are a mechanic?
Mechanic?
Yes, I'm a mechanic. Very good.
Great, guys. You got it. Aprendieron algo buenísimo hoy. Okay. So, our last... Yep.
How pronunciation psicólogo or psicóloga?
Yeah, we said psychologist. Psychologist.
Mm-hmm. I am now a good psychologist.
Angel is not a good psychologist. Why?
No. No.
It's bullying.
A psychology woman.
What?
Yes.
Okay. Angel, tell him who's
he can recommend her.
Okay. Like... The boss. Okay, guys. Come on. No bullying in the class. Let's go. Let's continue. So on your notebook, you have a duty, you have another task, which is about making open questions. Let's do it together, okay? Vamos a cerrar con eso. Let's do it together. Let me find it first. There it is. Okay, open questions. You see? You have to create 6 open questions. Por eso el ejercicio en parejas, okay? Pages 37 and 36. Las páginas 37 y 36. Wait a minute. Yeah, 37 and 38. Yes, y tenés que crear las preguntas, las 6 preguntas para hacérselas a tu compañero. So, let's see. I want you to select someone. Tienen 10 segundos para pensar en uno de sus compañeros o de sus compañeras. Okay, miren las fotitos. Chávez Campos is Lorena, but she feels sick, a little bit sick today. So, de los que ven las fotos, ok? Pensé en uno de tus compañeros, mira el nombre. Tienes que retar a ese compañero, ok? Haciéndole una pregunta y la tienen que contestar. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, thank you. I thought about Michelle. Okay, I thought about Michelle. So let's go with Michelle first. Y luego Michelle va a dirigirle la pregunta a su compañero, okay? Good, Michelle.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Easy, teacher, easy, dígame. Okay, despacio, fácil, teacher, fácil. Okay, what time do you really... take a shower?
I take a shower at 5 a.m.
Really?
Yeah, really.
Okay, good. Now you go. Make a question with what, okay, to your classmate.
Okay. Veronica.
Yeah.
What time do you wake up? What time do you wake up?
I wake up 5 a.m.
Okay.
Easy. Very good. Liz, make the question to someone else.
Yeah. Yancy, Lisbeth.
Yancy? Now you go with when, Liz.
When?
Easy.
When you do drink coffee?
When do you drink coffee?
I drink coffee in the morning.
Excellent. Very good, Yancy. Your turn.
Rafa.
Repeat. Payback. Yancy, repeat.
Payback.
I say payback time. Repeat, Yancy. Payback time.
Payback time.
¿Qué quiere decir? Revenge, venganza.
Okay. Payback time. Así mira. Okay. Cuando lo veas y te vengas, decirle payback time.
Payback time.
Ask me.
Payback time.
I'm ready.
Ok, Rafa, okay. Vas a decir yo. Shoot me. Shoot me.
Shoot me.
I'm disparame, ready. Disparame, dale. Ajá.
Okay. I'm ready.
Voy.
When
do you sleep in the work?
Jose, pay attention. When do you sleep at work? When do you sleep at work?
Como digo, how do you say en ningún momento?
Be honest. Never. You say never. I never sleep at work. Repeat. I never.
Sleep at.
Work.
Work.
One more time.
I have pictures.
Ah.
Okay. Jose, you're taking notes, right?
Years. It was years ago.
Oh, she has pictures. Oh my God. And it was years ago. Great job, guys. Okay, Rafa, who's next?
Maybes.
Maybes?
Yes.
Shoot me.
Ah, there you go. Shoot.
Shoot me.
Okay. Where do you work?
Ah, come on.
I work in the buffet. Oh,
I work buffet. In a buffet.
In a buffet.
Buffet. I work in a buffet. Excellent. Okay, and last one. Well, let's continue. Maybe it's who's next? Where?
Edwin Rolando.
Okay, shoot me.
Where do you have breakfast?
Do you have breakfast? Where do you have breakfast?
I don't have breakfast.
Me neither. Yo tampoco. Very good. And last question. Edwin, go.
Vanessa, where do you go to vacation?
Why?
Why? Ah, okay. Why? Why do you study English?
Oh. Why do you study English?
Because I want to improve my English.
Oh my God. Great job. Okay, guys. See? Very simple. Great job. Muy bien, chicos. Eso estuvo súper bien. Ahora necesito que ustedes hagan eso todos los días con mí mismo, con ustedes mismos, ¿verdad? Háblense, pregúntense cosas. Si no le gusta la pregunta, le dicen, no te voy a contestar. Ok. Good, let's go. A la Patricia.
Y luego Linares. Vamos al psicólogo.
Rafa, le hablan.
A la Patricia Linares Galdames.
Ángel, like your comment.
Wait. A la Patricia, here. Ok, Ana Michelle Guevara.
Here.
Sánchez. Blanca Argelia Fabián Mejía. Se nos pudo unir. Edwin Rolando Méndez Chicas.
Here.
Eric Gabriel Salvador Benavides. There. Okay. Flora Lorena Chávez Campos.
Here.
Thank you. Gilberto Eli Mendoza Rosales. Gilberto se habrá desconectado, supongo. Sí, ok. Gloria Elizabeth Linares Galdames.
Here.
Thank you. Jennifer Carolina Gallardo Chacón. José Ángel Pereira Romero.
Here.
Yo, José Marvin Portillo Argueta. Karen Alexis Juárez Vigil. Karen, perdón, Carla Vanessa García de Pérez.
Here.
Mavis Yvette Milla Contreras.
Here.
Néstor Iván Ramírez Galeano.
Here.
Ofelia Orellana Arce.
Here.
Rafael Ernesto González Ventura.
Here.
Reinaldo Bonilla Martínez. Verónica Lizeth Sánchez Pérez.
Here.
And Yancy Lisbeth Hernández Mejía. Good.
Here.
Thank you, guys. Gracias por estar un día más con nosotros. Vamos a cerrar con el comentario del compañero José, que parece que tiene una inquietud. ¿No? Lleva a decir que se le había ido el internet, que no se movió. Ok, all good? ¿Todo bien? ¿Questions? ¿No? Bien, chicos, les veo el lunes. Ojo, quienes no hayan completado la hasta la unidad 3 y el midterm, tienen hasta mañana en el mediodía para poder completar todo eso. ¿Ok? You can do it. Si tienen alguna pregunta, me escriben en la mañana y voy a estar. ¿Ok?
Okay,
good night.
Bye.
Good night. Have some rest. Bye-bye.
Bye.